Look, we all know Twilio Segment is the coolest thing since the adoption of container orchestration for seamless microservice communication. So let's talk about it. This is Twilio Update, the bi-weekly show that takes you behind the scenes of the latest developments in the Twilio ecosystem. I'm your host, Alex Goldman. First up, we'll dive into our changelog, where we'll introduce generative custom operators for voice intelligence, putting AI-driven insights right at your fingertips. Then, we'll explore new speech models that take real-time transcription and narration to new heights. After that, we'll do a segment on Segment, covering how this powerful CDP can transform the way you collect, unify, and activate customer data. And finally, we'll wrap up by highlighting a few can't-miss upcoming events and resources. So stick around. This is your one-stop shop for staying ahead of the Twilio curve. Welcome to the Twilio Changelog. Today, we're talking generative custom operators and the magic of Twilio Picks Mode for TTS and STT. Listen, we may have changelog updates, but I promise we're still the same old Twilio. Our first big headline is all about voice intelligence getting, you guessed it, more intelligent. Twilio has introduced generative custom operators, which use generative AI to understand exactly what you're looking for in your calls. Simply describe your goals like spotting upsell opportunities or checking script adherence, and the system delivers actionable insights at scale. No need for fancy schmancy tech talk. Not convinced? You drive a hard bargain. But here are some ways they can help. Generative custom operators feature call scoring, meaning they automatically rate agents' performance based on your custom criteria. Through these operators, you can maintain script adherence by verifying that your agents are sticking to the script, something my producers desperately wish I would do. Hey, who wrote that? Another highlight is competitive intelligence. The generative custom operator notes if a competitor is mentioned and gets context on why they came up. They contain upsell identification, meaning the system can identify potential sales movements in any conversation. Lastly, they employ lead qualification and extract indicators of lead quality based on buying signals and sentiment. It's like having a mini data scientist living inside your call transcript. Twilio wants to be clear, there are no miniature scientists actually living within your call transcripts that we know of. Our next update is that Twilio has upgraded its speech-to-text and text-to-speech capabilities for the gather and say TwiML verbs. This includes incorporating the latest technologies from Google, which is version 2 of their speech APIs, and DeepGram with their Nova 2 speech models. Gather offers a flexible provider selection. For speech-to-text, developers can now choose specifically which speech model or provider they want to use for their different parts of their application. This choice can be made per individual prompt, which allows for greater customization based on the needs of the application. For instance, using one provider for general conversation and another for recognizing numbers or addresses. Can't decide? Let us handle it with Twilio Picks Mode. Twilio will automatically select the best speech provider and model based on the language or other criteria you specify. This mode is designed to offer resilience. If one provider is slower down, Twilio can switch to another provider without any manual intervention, ensuring consistent service. We aren't just better listeners, we sound better too. To make things even better, we're also excited to announce that Google's new text-to-speech voice models are available with the Say TwiML verb. This includes the standard Google Voices, along with the WaveNet and Neural 2 premium voices. Now everyone smile and say TwiML. That's all for the changelog. Now let's move on to runtime. Twilio Segment is a customer data platform, or CDP. I know, another acronym, but don't tune out just yet, because Segment isn't just any CDP. Picture a customer-centric data library that helps businesses understand and interact with their customers in a more meaningful way. Beautiful, isn't it? CDPs are generally like a data library, but not all libraries are created equally. Some have limited options, struggle to meet the demands of customers, or impose limitations even inadvertently. And some just don't have a big enough sci-fi section. Segment, on the other hand, is like an endless library with unlimited options, allowing businesses to collect data from a vast number of sources, organize it into unified customer views, and act upon it to better engage customers at scale. Segment collects data from every touchpoint, unifying customer reactions into a complete profile. It processes and activates data instantly, not hours or days later. And it's built for the whole team, from data engineers to marketers to developers, with flexible and direct integrations to Twilio's messaging and marketing tools. With the rise of AI for customer interactions, having this data organized and actionable becomes even more important because an AI is only as good as its data. So what exactly does a CDP do and how does Twilio Segment take it further? Let's break it down. Step one, collect data. A CDP's first job is to gather customer data from multiple sources, websites, mobile apps, backend servers, and data warehouses. Most CDPs collect this data in batches, which means delays. Twilio Segment does this in bullet time. Sorry, I watched The Matrix again last night. Twilio Segment does this in real time. Developers can drop in a simple JavaScript snippet, and Segment starts tracking user interactions immediately. It pulls in data from web, mobile, CRM systems, support tools, ad platforms, and more without manual stitching. It even allows custom data sources, meaning businesses with unique data streams like IoT devices or in-store transactions can integrate them without heavy engineering work. Faster collection means businesses can react instantly, whether it's personalizing a website experience or sending a timely message. No more offering discounts to customers on products they've already purchased. Let them get mad about something else. Step two, govern data. Once data is collected, it needs to be organized and standardized. Otherwise, it's a mess. Twilio Segment automates data quality best practices. Our protocols ensure consistency. For example, say marketing logs customer email, but sales logs email address. Classic sales move. Segment will catch that inconsistency before it causes problems, like a data consistency spidey sense. Or take schema detection. Segment automatically detects and corrects broken data. Not only that, Segment structures every data such as clicks, purchases, or interactions, and provides tools to validate, enforce, and resolve issues. The result? No duplicate records, no broken dashboards, and no more compliance headaches. Step three, synthesize and unify. CDPs don't just collect and route data, they connect scattered interactions into a single united profile. Once again, most CDPs require batch processing for identity resolution, which means delays in merging customer activity. Twilio Segment does this in real time. Let's say a user browses your site anonymously. Segment will assign them an anonymous ID. Now, what happens if that same user makes a purchase later on? Segment instantly merges this new activity into their existing profile, giving businesses a complete view of the customer journey across web, mobile, and backend systems. Real-time data is great, but it doesn't tell the whole story. Businesses often need historical insights to enrich real-time interactions. That's why they rely on ETL, extract, transform, and load, to gather and structure past data for analysis. But getting that data back into operational tools is another challenge. That's where reverse ETL comes in. With reverse ETL, Segment pulls insights from data warehouses back into active tools, so historical data can be used in the moment. Imagine that anonymous user from earlier finally logs in. As it turns out, they're a VIP customer with loyalty points. Whoa. With reverse ETL, that loyalty data is instantly sent back from the warehouse into Segment, making it available for real-time personalization. This means businesses don't just store customer data, they use it to improve real-time engagement. Step four, engage and activate. And that's the key. Most CDPs stop at organizing data, but Twilio Segment takes it a step further, turning insights into immediate, personalized engagements through audiences and journeys. Let's say you want to group customers based on behavior. With Segment, you can instantly create an audience based on any criteria. For example, customers who abandoned their cart in the last 48 hours, VIP customers who haven't made a purchase in 3 months, users who clicked on an ad but didn't sign up. Once you've built an audience, what do you do with it? This is where journeys come in. Let's take that cart abandonment audience. We don't just collect that data, we act on it. A customer abandons their cart, Segment detects it in real time. If they don't return in 3 hours, they get a personalized SMS reminder. If they don't check out, a carrier pigeon is on its way with a discount code. Okay, that last example probably doesn't exist, but boy, I wish it did. Because Segment is natively integrated with Twilio, these messages aren't just emails. They can be SMS, RCS, WhatsApp, voice calls, or even live chat prompts. Managing multiple data pipelines like these can be cumbersome for technical teams. Segment eliminates this hassle. With over 700 pre-built integrations, Segment lets businesses effortlessly route real-time customer data to tools like ad platforms, email and SMS services, CRMs, and support systems. Segment simplifies pipeline management, making it easy for teams to quickly swap tools in and out of their tech stack without the headaches of manual data handling. This ensures the right messages always reach the right person at precisely the right time. A standard CDP collects and routes data. Twilio Segment collects, organizes, unifies, and activates it without delays, without extra engineering, and without unnecessary complexity. If your business relies on customer data to drive engagement, Twilio Segment makes it actually useful. If you're excited to get started with Segment, check out all the awesome content over in the Segment University or attend a Segment webinar to learn live from experts. And that's your runtime update for this week. With that, we come to the build section, where we hear from the wonderful creators at the forefront of Twilio's technology. Today, the brothers behind Appella AI, James and George Strayson. These two are developing AI agents capable of nuanced, hyper-personalized interactions across multiple channels in the retail space. We got to hear their truly omnichannel vision for unifying the customer experience and breaking down the silos between these different touchpoints.
What we want to do is actually make the whole thing all together in kind of like one piece. And what I mean by that is, let's say you've created this branded AI to represent this personal shopper on the retailer's website. But now when you reach out to customer service over the phone, you're now speaking to that same AI agent. You're speaking to that same voice. You're familiar with that brand. When you get reached out by a personalized email or SMS, that's still that same AI agent that you can then talk to. You can ask it a question, either over email, text, WhatsApp, and you just have that consistent brand voice across all touch points. And that's what we're really focused on. I think that's a really fascinating idea on how do you capture a brand's essence within an AI model and yet it be consistent across all these different touch points.
And then the added value for the brand, in addition to for the customers James just mentioned, is now when you have that omnichannel experience, your data is no longer in silos and you actually collectively can really understand your customer when you're not separating each touch point that you have with them using a different system, a different framework, and the complexity of it is basically simplified.
Yeah, and by building a solution first, deploying it on a website, that's normally the first place where a shopper, you know, gets to meet that brand. We're hitting it at that point in the customer journey, but then we're using that data across throughout the customer journey, all the way to marketing emails, you know, understanding a bit more on the brand. Maybe there's a meetup of people who all love, you know, red couches, as I just mentioned.
Red couch.
You know, who knows? Whatever.
It's a niche one.
But
we keep mentioning it.
Maybe we're the buyers. But yeah, that's what we want to do. Really get on these touch points, really utilize that data as much as possible to deliver as much value as possible for those retailers.
I love how James and George are thinking so holistically about how AI can improve every aspect of the customer experience. And did you notice their plug for unifying data? Can you say CDP? Now, let's take a look at what's coming up in the Twilio ecosystem. If you want to hear directly from the people working on Twilio's latest features, join us for the quarterly releases webinar that Steph and I will be hosting on March 26th. We'll be covering RCS, messaging enhancements, voice intelligence, AI assistance, Flex, and Segment updates. Because I know you all didn't get nearly enough Segment talk today. On April 8th, Twilio's Transform Together event is coming to my hometown of Chicago. Shout out Chicago-style hot dogs. Absolutely no ketchup for me. We'll be bringing customers, prospects, and partners together for a half day of networking and learning. Expect a keynote from Christina Tosi, CEO and founder of Milk Bar, two breakout sessions plus a networking reception where you can connect with Twilio experts. If you're in Chicago or want an excuse to visit, don't miss it. On the same day, April 8th, at 9 a.m. Pacific, noon Eastern, we're running a virtual Twilio Forge session dedicated to AI-powered virtual agents. The goal? Walk away with a fully functional AI assistant prototype using Twilio's conversational AI tools. It's a hands-on, build-your-own-bot experience led by Sarah Biffle. All right, honesty time. Did you genuinely not get enough of Twilio Segment? I get it. You're going to want to check out Unlocking the Future of Personalization, Smarter Engagement at Scale on April 9th at 9 a.m. Pacific, noon Eastern. In this interactive product demo, you get to hang out with Bryn Saunders, the main contributor to today's runtime on Twilio Segment. Finally, drum roll please. On May 14th through 15th, it's Twilio's biggest event of the year, Signal in San Francisco. Signal brings together developers, business leaders, and innovators for industry-leading companies for 2 days of networking and hands-on learning. We'll explore how Twilio simplifies the way you build customer relationships. Hope to see you there. Now, if you can't make it to an in-person event, check out Twilio's on-demand developer webinars at developers.twilio.com. You can catch our live streams every Tuesday, Thursday, and now Wednesdays at 2 p.m. Eastern on Twilio Devs Twitch and on demand at Twilio Devs YouTube. Yes, the rumors are true. We have a new show coming your way. Andrew and Rashab are taking over the Twilio airwaves on Wednesdays for Build a Blog, where they revisit and update some of your favorite Twilio blog posts and beyond, fixing broken code and making sure it works in today's tech landscape. And as always, Bianca and I host A/B testing on Tuesdays, and Brent and Chris host the Developer Lens on Thursdays. That's 3 straight days of Twilio streams. Don't say we never did anything for you. Final note for all you Twilio update heads out there, I'm taking a vacation, which means the next update will be in 3 weeks. I know, but I have to go. These dives aren't gonna scuba themselves. I'm Alex Goldman, and this was Twilio Update. I'll see you in 3 weeks.